Hi everyone, Canoopsy here, and the Essential Phone was destined for success, but ended up being a complete and utter flop. Due to the price, the jank cameras, availability, and a series of other issues always popping up with the phone, or even the company itself. But it's one of the biggest cases of an epic phone revival moment, when the price was slashed to $499 from the initial $699 price tag. Basically, a huge drop in price took this phone from dead on arrival to maybe I'll consider it. First, a quick refresh on the phone itself. Epic design with great materials, titanium and ceramic, so it both looks incredible, feels incredible, and also it's a very solid, very durable phone. Up front you have an LCD panel with the now sort of iconic Essential cutout for the front-facing camera, and the display itself looks pretty decent, but I still do wish it was OLED for the better overall contrast and colors. Powering the phone is a Snapdragon 835 processor with 4GB of RAM and some fairly decent battery life, giving you a full day of usage for most people. And actually running on the phone is a super stock, clean version of Android. Basically, stock Android, pure Android, with no additions or changes except for the Essential camera app. And also, speaking of cameras, the phone has a pretty weak set of cameras. So the very few people who actually bought this phone when it was first released could live with the high price tag and the initial problems, as they did actually pay for the phone, but what they really couldn't deal with was the camera experience. When I first got the phone, I really thought the camera experience was extremely lackluster, especially indoors or in lower light. It was basically unusable. But since then, Essential heard all the criticism and all the negatives about the actual camera experience and has been putting out software updates on a quite frequent basis to improve the camera and add some new features in. Based on some of these recent photos, shots are actually quite good, surprisingly, but not like incredibly Pixel 2 level epic. Essentially, shots went from, that's a terrible looking photo, looks like absolute shit, to, okay, that's a fairly decent photo. Essential also added in a new portrait mode that's actually quite impressive, especially in bright light. You can adjust blur before shooting, and results are totally surprisingly usable, and actually surprisingly good. The 4K video recording on this phone doesn't really look too bad either, but the lack of stabilization makes it kind of hard to watch. Electronic stabilization is supposedly coming soon in a future update, and there's kind of a temporary stabilization toggle after you take a video, but that's not really an ideal solution. The Essential camera app still isn't the best ever or most stable, but the time it takes to actually take a picture has definitely improved. Moving on, Essential has improved the software and glitches quite a bit here as well, but there are some bugs here and there. Especially if you read some online reviews, you can definitely find a few examples of some of the issues that people are experiencing, including signal strength for some carriers. I'm using the Essential phone on TELUS here in Canada, and so far I've been pretty much fine with reception, but this may vary depending on your carrier or whereabouts you live. I have experienced some random app crashes or just things that aren't loading properly or just some general slowness here and there, but Essential seems to be pretty committed to actually improving the experience with future software updates. So it has gotten a lot better than before, and it's getting much more stable with each version that sort of comes out. Side note, animations feel extremely slow on this phone before you actually tweak anything, so go to your settings, turn on developer options, and speed up those animations as soon as you get this phone, and it's gonna feel a whole lot faster. It's kind of sad to say, but likely Essential as a phone company won't be around for too long after this phone, or maybe the next one, unless they can turn things around with a brand new offering, price cut this phone even further, and completely fix the software problems that have plagued this phone since it first came out. The phone has definitely gotten a whole lot better since it was first released, with a whole bunch of software fixes and the epic price cuts as well. But still, for $499, I'd still recommend the OnePlus 5T as my clear choice, just for the better support, better experience, better specifications, and much better cameras. If you can pick up this phone for $400 US or less, or buy it discounted on contract, it's a bit harder to pass up, especially since updates will continuously improve this phone's overall experience. But if smartphone design is the most important thing to you above everything else, and you don't mind the overall price tag, then this phone won't disappoint. It's the best build phone, and one of the best looking phones I've ever used. Let me know your thoughts on the Essential phone in the comments down below, and thank you for watching.